Topping the news this evening, the country paused to pray today. A 24-hour curfew in effect prevents large gatherings, including churches, church services, presenting an unprecedented restriction due to the threat of COVID-19. Today, an alternative in some trying times during a national service of prayer and fasting. The corporate prayer against a collective foe. The church, though unable to assemble physically, gathered virtually today to touch and agree on the assurances of the faith.
Together, we can call on our God to help us through these uncertain times. But don't be afraid, because God promised never to leave you, nor will he forsake you.
Prayers and admonition. The Christian Council President, Bishop Delton Fernander, led the holy war against COVID-19 and the anxiety it's produced.
And we've realized that our God is our help in the time of trouble. The government has put measures in place to limit our physical contact with one another, to slow the spread of coronavirus. And I take this time to applaud the government in taking such strong measures.
We rejoice with those who have recovered. And we pray that in this and all things, you would help us, Heavenly Father, to trust you, to depend upon you, to call upon your name.
The leaders must pray for all those who are healthcare workers on the front line of caring for those who are infected with the virus.
The pandemic has caused us to look up, realize what's important, that the God who created us is the God who can speak to plagues and diseases and tell them, peace be still.
Though separated for now, the service was a reminder of the faith that binds us, often beginning with these three words.
You are our Father who art in heaven. That means that from your vantage point, there is nothing going on in our country and in our lives that you do not already know about.